All right, good evening students. I welcome you for another session on transition elements, D and F block element. Dekho, we are doing D and F block elements and we have discussed many important questions. We have discussed their electronic configuration, their ionization enthalpies, atomization energy students. Then we have discussed their melting point students. Then we have discussed the electrode potential values, which are very, very important questions. And we have made attempt to solve more and more questions. So our session is beginning today on magnetic and color properties of the transition element, which is going to be an important question. Before that, student, as usual, student, we are giving you questions on the screen to answer, student. This is a warm-up exercise, students. The question is there on the screen before we begin our session. Student, first question: in the series of scandium to zinc, the enthalpy of atomization of zinc is lowest. Explain why. Important question, student. This was put up in the paper. So you have 1 minute to answer the question, students. In the series scandium to zinc, the enthalpy of atomization of zinc is the lowest. Why? What is the answer for these students? Enthalpy of atomization we have discussed. Yes, what do you mean by enthalpy of atomization, student? That you are converting or removing an atom or solid to gas. You are going from solid to gas, student. So energy is required. So that is the enthalpy of atomization. So how much will be required, student? If you want to go from solid to the gas, student, or you are removing atoms. Atomization, you are doing atomization, student. They are held together by some forces of attraction, student, and you are removing those attractive forces by applying energy. What would be the reason for this, student? You already have been told how to answer these questions by me. Always go for the configuration. Look in the electronic configuration of zinc, students. The answers will be there.
Yes, sir.
What is the electronic configuration of zinc, students?
Sir, it is 3d10 4s2.
Zinc is argon 4s2 3d10. So the shell is completely filled and therefore there are no unpaired electrons, students. There are no unpaired electrons. Therefore, the bonding will be very weak. How we told you when we discuss the atomization that it depends on the number of unpaired electrons. More the number of unpaired electrons, student, more they will be attracted, more they will, there will be bonding between them, students. And as the number of unpaired electrons will decrease, what will happen, students? What will happen? Their enthalpy of atomization will decrease. So we have already told you.
Yes, sir.
What is the reason for this such an increase, student? It is maximum around the middle and then it falls as the electrons get paired up. So in zinc, there are no unpaired electrons. D and 4, as you can see, they are completely filled, student. Therefore, the enthalpy of atomizing lowest. Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
It depends on the number of unpaired electrons. More the number of unpaired electrons, student, more they can participate in bonding. And here, you know, which of the following is not an element of the first transition series? You are given 4 choices, student. Which is the right answer? Which of the following is not an element of the first transition series? I hope by now the names of the first transition elements are known to us, students. What is the answer?
Yes, sir.
Which is the correct choice here, student? Which is not an element of the first transition series?
Sir, magnesium.
That is the correct answer. Because you already, I said this series should be remembered: scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc. Very important. Atomic number 21 to 30. Student, you must remember this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. That is the correct answer. Next question, the number of unpaired electrons in gaseous species of manganese 3 plus Cl, 3 plus manganese and vanadium 3 plus are the most student in this is a 3D transition series student. This should be chromium 3 plus manganese 3 plus chromium 3 plus and vanadium 3
plus. So the answer is A part.
Manganese 3 plus a number of, what is manganese 3 plus, what is the configuration? 3 plus is D4.
Yes, sir.
So then D4 will be 1, 2, 3. How many unpaired electrons? 4. And then chromium 3 plus will be. What is chromium? Here is a chromium 24. So 2. And 1, 3. How many are there? 3. 3 unpaired electron. It is a D3. 1, 2, 3 students. 3 unpaired electrons. And what is?
Yes, sir.
Vanadium 3 plus. This is vanadium is 23. So how much will be there? 2. D2. 1 and 2, D2. So this is the correct answer. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next question. Fe2 plus is more stable than Fe3 plus is more stable than Fe2 plus because more the charge on the atom, more stability. Configuration of Fe2 plus is 3D5. Fe3 plus is 3D5. Fe2 has a larger size. Fe3 ions are colored, hence are more stable. What is the right answer, students? You have iron. Electronic configuration is very important. The first time I told you, a lot of answers will be there on the basis of electronic configuration in the paper, students. So we must know it in the
quality. So this is, yes, sir. This is because the. Sir, I think B part is wrong because it says Fe3S, it says D5 in both of them.
Huh?
I think so. Sir, I think option is wrong. B option is wrong, I think.
Iron is more stable than Fe2 because you have to give the which is the correct choice. Correct choice.
Sir, I think B part has a mistake. Read one, please.
What is the atomic number of iron? 26? So 26 will be mean student 4s2 3d6 and what will be iron 2 plus 3d6 and what will be iron 3 plus 3d5. So 3d5 is
what I'm saying is in B part it says configuration of Fe2 plus is also 3d5 and not 3d6. That's what I'm saying is wrong.
Yeah, Fe2 plus is
3D6. Yeah, question says 3D5. So I'm saying wrong.
It is 6 and?
Yes, I'm saying B part.
This is okay. So that means the B will be now the correct answer because this is more stable. Half filled orbitals are extra stable, you already know. A lot of questions are to be answered on this basis. I told you in the paper, students. Okay. That's
correct. Yes, sir.
All right, thank you for the correction which you have done. Which of the following pair of ions have the same electronic configuration, student? Which have the same electronic configuration? these pairs. Again, we as that series should be remembered, because atomic numbers will be known, then only we will see how many electrons are there in the s and d. 2 plus or 3 plus mean 4 electrons in the s are not there, because if 2 electrons are removed means they will go from 4s. Then what is, you have to see how many electrons are there in the d count. So what is the correct answer then? We must learn atomic numbers.
B part.
Iron 3 plus. What is the atomic number of iron? 26.
Six. Yes, sir.
So it will become 3d5. Iron 3 plus will be 3d5, student. And then what is manganese? Atomic number 25.
Yes, sir.
Then what will be Mn2 plus? 3d5. So they have the same configuration. This is the correct answer. Iron 3 plus and manganese 2 plus both have 3d5 configuration, students. They have the same configuration. This is a good practice for writing the
question
of the transition element. The last question on the screen, the melting point of copper is higher than zinc because
sir, I think this is easy, sir. D part.
The S as well as D electron of copper are in, what is the configuration of copper, student? Copper is 29, zinc is 30.
Yes, sir.
4S.
Copper 3D10, 4S1.
3D10. Copper is 4S1. What is this? 4S.
Zinc.
3D10.
2, 3D10.
Now yes, this sir. D is filled. This is not involved in bonding. S. What is written? The electrons of copper are involved in metallic bonding. The S as well as D of copper are involved. No, this S and D is not involved, only these electrons. But then the electrons of copper are involved in bonding. There is no electrons involved in bonding here because they are paired. Paired electrons do not take part in bonding, paired electrons, students. But it has unpaired in the S, not in the D. So C is the correct one. Got my point? Unpaired electron is there in the S, not in the D, in the case of copper. So electronic configuration, we will write that. We will get a lot of answer. Clear to you? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
All right. So that was a
good, yes, sir.
Good yes, exercise, sir. And you could
revision.
Almost.
Yes, sir. Good revision, sir.
All right. I thank you for answering the question, student. That is a good webinar. You have good practice. You know what type of questions are coming in the transition element, students. Now, one mark questions are there, student. We have to just think and then only answer. Four choices are given, one is right. Then reasoning, assaulting questions are given. All this we have to work out, student, work out. No mugging. Electronic configuration to be learned clearly.
Yes, obviously.
Now we're coming to another important property of the transition element, student. Magnetic properties of the transition element. What are the magnetic properties? Do you know anything about this, student? Magnetic. What do you mean by magnetic property, student? What do you mean by magnetic property? That actually what you find, student, in the chapter of solids, we have also told you what are the magnetic properties. But in transition metals, mainly we will experience two types of magnetic property, student. What are those, student? You know, certain substances are paramagnetic.
Yes, sir.
And there are others which are diamagnetic. And in solid state, we learned more about it. Ferromagnetic substances, student, ferrimagnetic and anti-ferromagnetic substance in solid state. So, but in this transition metal, we are mainly going to concentrate and focus on two important things. Large number of transition metal ions show paramagnetic behavior. What do you mean by paramagnetic behavior, student? Paramagnetic substances are those which are, can you tell me what are paramagnetic substances? They are attracted, student, by the magnetic field. by the magnetic field student. If I bring the magnetic field, they will be attracted towards the magnetic field, right?
Yes, sir.
And diamagnetic substances are those, they are repelled by the magnetic field students. Repelled by the magnetic field. And the transition metal ion students show mainly these two types of behavior. So when we apply magnetic field,
yes, sir.
They show a lot of transition metal ions in show paramagnetic behavior. What could be the reason for these students? Why certain substances are paramagnetic student? Why, you know, electron student, electron is a charged particle. And when a charged particle moves, student, in physics you have learned it, it has a field around it. You have seen in physics, student, charged particle has a magnetic field. It has a magnetic field. Yes or no? When electric current flows,
yes, sir.
Then magnetic field is created. Now here the electron behaves like a tiny bar magnet, student. Electron is like a tiny bar magnet, student. Bar magnet means something like this. But the thing is, the electron is under moving. How it is moving around the nucleus? You are saying there are two motions, student. One is the orbital motion of the electron. Orbital motion of electron, students. What do you mean? And second, you are saying is the spin of the electron, student. Spin of electron. What it means, students? You know about it? That you are saying this is a nucleus. The electron is orbiting, students. Okay? And it's a bar magnet.
Yes, sir.
It's a bar magnet. It is when charged. It is a charged particle. When it moves, it will have a magnetic field around it, students. So there's an orbital motion of the electron that will create a orbital magnetic moment, student. In physics, we're talking of little bit of physics, orbital magnetic moment, student. Electron has an orbital magnetic moment, student. What is the second part of it? The electron is spinning around its axis. You see this electron? This is spinning. And what type of spin? The spin magnetic moment, student, spin magnetic moment. Why? What is happening? See, this is your electron, which is behaving like a bar magnet. You say it can spin anti-clockwise, or we show sometimes it can spin clockwise. So you know, we have told you in quantum number, spin quantum number, student, there are two values, plus half and minus half. The electron can spin either in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction. So what will happen? Then these north and south, and south and north. And if the electrons are paired, student, what happens? This electron is paired. Then these spin magnetic moments cancel out each other. The spin magnetic moments, student.
Yes, sir.
Cancel out, because the equal and opposite spins are there. One north south and other south north. What will happen? So because you know, when electrons will be paired, they will have opposite spin, student. All the four quantum
Will
be same, Pauli's exclusion principle. But if unpaired electrons are present, student, then what happens? They have a spin magnetic moment. They will have a spin magnetic moment, student. Yes or no? Because it is like a bar magnet, student. South. So it will have unpaired electrons will have spin magnetic moment, as well as orbital magnetic moment is there. What happens for the 3D series, what happens? The orbital magnetic moments are quenched. The orbital magnetic moment are quenched, students. They are just canceling each other. So we don't consider that. Then what we use? We are going and interesting to calculate, student, the spin magnetic moments. What? Spin magnetic moments.
Yes, sir.
So for the 3D series, students, the magnetic moments of the electrons is due to unpaired electrons. And we will be interested in the spin magnetic moment, student. The spin magnetic moments depends on the number of unpaired electrons. So the magnetic moment is determined by, For the 3D series, this orbital magnetic moment, which we are not considering, student, this is quenched. And what we are using, spin of the electron, spin magnetic moment. The spin magnetic moment is dependent on the number of unpaired electrons. So spin only formula will be used to calculate the magnetic moments, the magnetic moment. The formula is, student, here, spin magnetic moment formula, N into N plus 2, the units are Bohr magneton, student, Bohr magneton. The Bohr magneton is the unit we will use for calculation, student. We already told you in solid state, we have also told you how do you calculate. N is the number of unpaired electron, students. ठीक है? Questions will be there in the paper, student, now. If you have unpaired electrons, you put the value of N. Put the value of N, you will get the magnetic moment in Bohr magneton. In Bohr magneton, student. For example, if I say titanium 3 plus, ठीक है? Now the question is asked, question, titanium 3 plus, is it paramagnetic? And if it is, calculate the magnetic moment. You have 1 minute to answer the question.
Yes, sir.
Calculate the magnetic moment, students. Okay. I said electronic configuration should be very well known to all the students, then only we will be able to answer the question. Now this is a question to you. Titanium, is it paramagnetic? Student, calculate the magnetic moment.
So the electronic configuration is 3d1.
Okay, titanium atomic number is how much? Scandium, titanium, titanium is 22.
So 22, yes sir, so
3d2, and titanium 3 plus will be 3d1. 3d count is 3d1. So what is the number of, it has one unpaired electron?
Yes sir.
And one unpaired electron, student. Therefore it will be paramagnetic. And what will be the value of this magnetic moment then? Mu is equal to square root of N, N plus 2. What is the value coming?
Yes, sir.
Root of 3. What is the root of 3, student?
Sir, 1 plus 2. Yes, sir.
Approximately 1.73 Bohr magneton.
Yes, sir.
To mention the units.
Yes, yes, sir.
So we can easily calculate the magnetic moments due to presence of the unpaired electron. Okay, students? Now I said, question 2, calculate magnetic moment of vanadium 2 plus.
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is the value coming, students?
So we finding the 2 minutes. 23. So, sir, this is so this is 3d3.
What is the atomic number of vanadium, student?
I'm sir 23.
Scandium, titanium, scandium, vanadium. 23 means 4s2. This is 4s2 and 3d3. Then vanadium, yes, plus will be 3d3. Then how many unpaired electrons? 3. Then what is the formula?
3, yes, sir. So
how much?
Plus 2, 5, 15. This is, sir, root 15.
Root 15 is approximately, root 16 is 4. It is slightly less than 4, student.
7.1.
Huh? No, square root.
Yes, sir.
Are square root. Square root of 15.
Oh, yes, sir.
What will be the value?
Sir, somewhere around
12.86 more.
Sir.
Are 4 the square 16 now? It will be slightly less.
Ah, so sorry, my bad. Yes, okay, yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
Okay. All right. And now you see that how we are calculating the magnetic moment, student. Question coming on the screen, student question coming on the screen. Find the magnetic moment of cobalt 2 plus ion, student. Cobalt 2 plus.
I'm finding, sir. Sir, cobalt is 27.
Okay.
So, finding, sir. So 3D7.
Then what is the value of the find the magnetic moment, student?
So I'm sorry, that will be 1 into 7, 7, 7, 50. So that will be root 63.
How many unpaired electron? Without unpaired electron, how can you calculate? What is the number of unpaired electrons? Tell me. What is the number of unpaired electrons, student? N value. How much is that?
Sir, N. Sir, the N is 4.
N is 4?
Wait.
Three. 6 and 7. N is 3,
student. Yeah, 3 is 3.
Then what will be the answer? Will be how much?
Sir, same, 3.86, root 15.
N into N plus 2, 3 plus 2, students. How much is square root of 15? 4 point.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry. 3.86. No, I'm sorry. So three, right now. 3.8 something.
Square, 3 point something. Okay.
Yes, 3.8 something.
So 3 point, whatever it is, 8, 6 or something like that. What do you find, student?
Mm-hmm.
Before that, I have calculated for which? That was? This has 3D3 electrons. Dekho, interesting thing. What is the point to be noted, star?
Mm-hmm.
3D3, it has 3 unpaired electrons. Theek hai?
Yes, sir.
And the magnetic moment was how much? Bohr magneton, I must write. 3.86 Bohr magneton. And now I am saying 3D7, student. 3D7. Theek hai? What is the total number of electrons in the D?
Yes, sir.
In the D, you can put maximum of, in the D orbital, student, you can put maximum of 10 electrons. So 10 electrons, right? So,
yes, sir.
10 minus 7 is how much? 3.
3.
This also has 3 unpaired electrons. This also has 3 unpaired electrons. So the value is same. Value is same.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, if I say 3DN and 3D10 minus N, student. 3DN and 3D10 minus N. What is the story here? If n value, I put student 7, then it is equal to this. ठीक है, n is the number of unpaired electrons.
Yes,
here there are 3 unpaired electrons, 10 minus 7. So if 3d n and 3d 10 minus n will have the same values of magnetic moment, student, point to be noted. Sometimes you will see that if I have 3d2 and if I have 3d8, student, what will happen? 3d8 will mean 10 minus 8, how many? 2 unpaired electrons.
Yes, sir.
And both of them will have the same value of the magnetic moment. Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Clear.
Interesting thing, if this is my number of unpaired electrons and number of unpaired electrons, students. And here is my value of the Bohr magneton, mu. If one unpaired electron is there, how much you are getting? Around 1.73. If two unpaired electrons are there, you are getting around 2.76. Three unpaired electrons, students, how much you are getting? 3.86. Four unpaired electrons, how much you are getting? Around 4.80.
4.8.
And maximum you can have is 5 unpaired electrons.
Yes, sir.
Value comes around 5.96. Therefore, the number of unpaired electrons, then the value lies between 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 3 and 4, and more towards the 4 side. See the connection?
Yes, sir.
I mean, I may not calculate in the paper if 4 choices are given. If 3 unpaired electrons, then the value should be around little less than 4. Which is around 3.8. If 5 unpaired electron is there, little less than 6. See, got it?
Yes, sir.
So here is a trick to, answer objective type of question, students. Objective type of question, student. Clear? And now he gave a question like,
yes,
this.
Sir.
The question was given in the paper on magnetic moment, student. He said, divalent ion in aqueous solution. Atomic number 25. ठीक है, ठीक है.
Yes, sir.
Is it paramagnetic? Calculate the magnetic moment. Okay, you have 1 minute to answer the question. Our mainly question answer session, student, going on. Question 2, he says, calculate the spin only magnetic moment M2 plus aqueous ion that is equal to 27. See, the questions are put like that. Atomic number is 25, element X.
Yes, sir.
Then 4s2, 3d, 5, then x2 plus will be what? If I say m2 plus metal, if it is metal m2 plus, then what is that? 3d5. What is the value of unpaired electrons?
5, sir.
5, then what will be the value of mu?
5 into 7, 35, root 35. So 5.9, I think.
Because if this is 5, I told you it will be little less than 6. So, Bohr magneton, you must write in the paper, students. Okay, next element, metal 27. Then what is the configuration of metal? 4s2 3d7. Then what is 2 plus count? D count is 3d7.
3d7, yes. So 3,
10 minus
3.
7, then 10 minus 7. We told you the formula 3d,
yes,
10
sir.
Minus 7, student.
7 to 3, 3, 3.
There will be 3.
3 into 5, 15, so 3.86.
So n will be 3, then what is mean?
And yes, 3.86.
Now you know it, student. How fast you can do it? 3 means it will be less than 4, little less than 4. Now, what do you think? 3,
yes,
6 more than. Okay. I have not even calculated anything. See, you understood the trick?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Can I proceed further? You want to note down? Note down, because I will explain everything. So that easy, easy, easy. If questions are given very fast, we can do the calculation. Student choices are given, then it is still good. One question will be there on magnetic moment, I am telling you. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Can I proceed further? Do you want to note down anything?
Copying 2 minutes.
Copy. Okay. Make your notes properly.
So proceed. Proceed. Yes, sir. Proceed.
Okay, all right, students, thank you very much for interacting and answering the questions. Your participation in webinar is very essential, because you will learn and you will be able to answer questions very fast in the paper, student. Another important property of transition element is formation of, students, colored ions. So you will find in solid as well as in liquid solution, student, in solution. They form colored ions, student. They are highly colored. Colored ions. Colored ions, students. You have seen, they show very, very beautiful colors in the chemistry lab. You have seen transition metal compound, copper sulfate compounds, active in color, student. Then you have seen cobalt, nickel, very, very beautiful colors. You see blue pink colors of cobalt ions, nickel ion green, and copper 2 plus blue, student. Now, what is the reason for the color of the transition element? First question. Question is, why do transition metal ions, student, form colored compounds?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 1 minute before I do this. I will try that you think more and more, so that the answers will come from you.
Yes, sir.
If you understand, then the science is easy. Chemistry is science, student, it should be understood. No mugging, no cramming. Students who are cramming, they will be out of the paper, because there will be objective type question. There will be reasoning asserting. You have to think and answer the question. So we
yes, sir.
Make an attempt to answer the question, students. The basic question is, why anything is colored? Why color comes, student? You have visible light, you know. and visible light, you are saying the portion which is visible to me, the sunlight has so many types of frequencies and wavelengths, you know, the whole range of
yes,
electromagnetic radiation. But visible part, you know, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red, student, there, the wavelengths, you are aware of that 400 to or 750 nanometers. What happens if there is an absorption of light in the visible part, some wavelength is absorbed in the visible part by the electrons, student. They are excited. They are excited. And then you will see a complementary color. Absorption of light should be there, student. And who will absorb the light? Electron, student. When electron, it will jump, student. It will be excited, student. Excited. Electrons will be excited by the absorption of light, student.
Yes, sir.
Visible part. Of some frequency, some wavelength. Then what will happen, student? The electron will go to an excited state, but electrons don't stay in the excited state for they are only for a short period of time, less than even 10 minus 8 seconds. They'll fall back. So what will happen, student? Then excitation will correspond to frequency of light absorbed, which generally lies in the visible region. And what we absorb, student? The complementary color, student. Complementary colors are absorbed, student. Now the question is, why the excitation of electron will take place? Where are the electrons, students, in the transition matter? D orbitals, D subshells, D orbitals, we told you. But we also told you, you have seen in the coordination compound, the 5D orbitals, student, 5D orbitals, which were degenerate, student, they split up. Did they split up into coordination compounds we did with you?
Yes, sir.
They split up into T2G and EG. In the case of octahedral and tetrahedral complexes also, we showed you, they will split up, students. The order becomes reverse in tetrahedral. Now, when this, if electrons are present here, student, what will happen? This is a splitting energy gap, student, delta O zero. And these electrons can absorb light in the visible region and can be excited. Can be excited. Okay? And if this,
yes, light, sir,
whatever value of this is, whatever frequency is absorbed according to that, we see the colors of the metal ions is due to color is due to DD transition. What we call this as DD transition, students?
Yes, sir.
This is a word which we write. The color of the transition metal ion or compound is due to DD transition. Electrons absorb energy, excite, and then what do you see? Complementary color, students. What do you see? So, what is the basic condition? What is the basic condition for metal ions to show color, student? In aqueous solution or in solid compounds or in solids, can you tell me what will be the condition, student? I will tell you a condition by which you will solve all the questions. What is the condition now? You have 1 minute to think. You are understanding,
yes,
everything,
sir.
I hope.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, understanding.
Okay. What is the condition, student? Dekho, first thing is, at least one unpaired electron should be there. If unpaired electrons are not there, there will be no color. There will be no color, student. Second,
yes, sir.
D0, D10. This is empty. Empty D, D0. And D10 is completely filled, student. Completely filled. They will become colorless.
Yes, sir.
It will become colorless, student. Ye note down, ye point aapko milega nahi, jo bhi bata raha hu. Isse you will be able to solve all the questions, students. All the questions. Theek hai ji? When you will note down, I will solve questions.
2 minutes.
Note kar lijiye, sir. Bahut important point hai.
Yes, sir.
Oh yeah, very good. Question was there in the paper, students. First question we have answered, why do transition elements form colored compound? What answer you are giving? Tell me fast. What is the reason of the color of the transition metal ion, students?
I'm telling, sir.
What is your answer? The color of transition metal ion is due to, what do you call that, DD transition?
Excuse me, I'm sorry, my dad was saying that he'll give you your fees in cash.
But I am out of town, I'm not in Delhi.
2 minutes. Okay, sir, my dad will see.
What is the answer which we are giving? Why do transition elements form?
I'm sorry, because of DD transition.
Why do transition form colored compounds, students? Because of DD transition, student. This
yes.
is what you have to write in paper, very important, student. Question 2 is on the screen, student. What we are saying, student? What we are saying, student? Important question. That scandium 3 plus colorless, student, colorless, okay, whereas titanium 3 plus aqueous are purple in color. Purple,
yes, sir.
In color. Explain. Explain, student. Question on the screen. You have 1 minute to answer the question, students. Every trick I told you one thing, that the basic electronic configuration must be known. Basic electronic configuration must be learned by the students so that they can answer the question, students.
Sir, because in TI 3 plus there is DD transition.
You have to show the number of electron, students. What is the answer? How do you write answers in the paper, student? What is scandium 3 plus? You have to show what is the configuration. Scandium is 21. 4s2 3d1, student. Scandium 3 plus is, student, 3d0. So what answer we will write? There are no electrons, student, in the d orbitals.
Yes, sir.
Hence, when there are no electrons, then what can happen? There can be no excitation of electrons. So no excitation or no d transition, students. No d transition possible. Therefore, it is colorless.
Yes, sir.
I told you the condition D0 will be always colorless. What happened in titanium 3 plus, student? This is 22, 4s2, 3d2, students. Then titanium 3 plus is 3d1, student.
Yes, sir.
So this has one unpaired electron. Condition I told you, so easy it will be. Therefore, there will be DD transition, and hence the color absorbed is in the visible part, and what we see, complementary color, purple.
Yes,
we
sir.
We have to show this in the paper, students. It's very important. Very important, students. Such questions are going to be there in the paper. But what I am telling you, you will not be able to do any mistake if you understand these things.
Yes, sir.
But answer should be written very correctly, student. Then only marks will be given. they want to see. I said electronic configuration is the key to all the answers that we have given. Most of the questions. Can I proceed further?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Question, answer student. All question important in the paper student. Question number three. It was a paper in the given the paper student. Paper.
Yes,
copper sulfate student. 5H2O. This is called a blue.
You know, excuse me, sir. Sir, how much fees is due?
Huh?
Sir, how much fees is due?
Same as you sent earlier, same. If you have student, blue vitriol is copper sulfate. This is blue vitriol.
Yes, sir.
This is blue. Okay? Now, this is blue in color. But zinc sulfate is colorless. Colorless student. Explain. Colorless means it's white actually.
Yes, sir.
White vitriol. That is blue vitriol. This is blue. So copper, or other words, you can say copper 2 plus student, copper 2 plus ions are blue, but Zn 2 plus are white or colorless. White is what we call as colorless student. White is what we call as colorless. Copper 2 plus we call blue student. What is the reason now? You have a question. Answer. 1 minute. What is the answer, students? What is the electronic configuration of copper 2 plus? What is copper 29, students? What is copper 2 plus? Copper 2 plus. How many? What is the D count? 3D9.
Yes, sir.
And what is Zn2 plus? 3D10. So this D is completely filled.
Yes, sir.
Three. What we are saying, then what answer we are writing, student? The 3D, as I said to you, 3D is completely filled, student. Condition I told you. No DD transition. Therefore, colorless or white. But here you have unpaired electron 3D9. I told you condition, just even one unpaired electron, sooner it becomes blue.
Yes.
Because it here DD transition can take place. Therefore, this is the whole game of the colors and the magnetic properties. There will be question on that student in the paper.
Mm-hmm.
And you can 100% answer the question. See how many questions we answered. You have answered, not me. But I just told you that this is the way we have to answer. You could answer almost all the questions. And they can be put in different form now in the paper. They can be put in the objective form, reasoning asserting form. But only those students who understand, they will be able to answer. Clear? There is no mugging or pratyabaji.
Yes, sir.
All right, then we end up here. We will continue more in the next class, student, with more important topics and more important question answer sessions on transition elements and all other chapters. And therefore, good night. I'll see you in the next class. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
I request you to share our videos with your friends, because it requires a lot of hard work and labor, student, online. We have to prepare lessons, lectures, and it is a lot of hard work. Before we give, we have to work main plan and so many things you can see here. So try to share our videos with your friends and ask them to subscribe the channel, as we will be uploading large number of important question answer sessions also in this, okay, which will help students score very good marks in the coming time. Okay, then good night, and
thank you, sir. Good night.
See you in the next class. Thank you for answering the question. Almost all the questions which you answered were right.
Thank you.